have an iTeam exclusive interview on protests, empowerment, policing, and the Black Lives Matter movement. Investigative reporter Sarah Wallace sat down with the brother and sister, co-founders of the New York movement, who happen to come from a legacy of civil rights activism.
Hawk Newsom is full of friendly fist bumps and handshakes in the Melrose Bronx neighborhood where he grew up and still lives. But the 43-year-old activist takes a far different tone on the protest platform.
You give us what we need!
The leader of Black Lives Matter of Greater New York is often front and center at demonstrations sparked by George Floyd's death. We recently spent several hours together. The conversation, candid.
Why do you think Black Lives Matter has caught on now?
Because people see Black Lives Matter as the civil rights struggle of our time. It's a bunch of frustrated people who are taken to the streets who don't have any, they don't view themselves as having any other path to go.
Do you condone the violence?
I don't condone nor I condemn the violence, but you can't keep treating people the way that we're being treated and expect them not to lash out. These are revolutionary times. This is times where we are burning down old societal norms and creating, planting seeds to sprout a new, beautiful, equitable world.
Okay, that term, burning down, has come back to suggest to some people that you are inciting violence.
Yes. When people hear me say burn down the system, they point and they say, you're a terrorist. What they don't see or listen to is the very next section where I say, I don't promote violence unless it's in self-defense.
He is unapologetic about being anti-police, even against minority officers like the NYPD 12, who've spoken out against alleged racial quotas.
You're still a part of that system.
But can't you change the system from within and make an effort to do that?
I don't believe so. I believe that we have to abolish police as we know them now and rebuild.
I'm a lawyer by training, but I'm a full-time revolutionary. Yeah.
Hawk says his law degree has helped with BLM strategy.
It's easy to paint me to be the big black man, but it's hard to see me as an intellectual who fights cerebrally.
But the cause has also gotten a boost from his sister, Shivana, who co-founded the group 5 years ago.
But what people don't know is the people who actually organize, who put the marches together, who make sure everyone's in place, it's tons of women. But you don't see us in front of the camera. Most of us don't get the opportunity to sit down with great women like yourself.
They embrace diversity within the movement, but have a singular view when it comes to the gentrification of traditionally minority neighborhoods.
I am against white people coming into neighborhoods and pushing poor black and brown people out.
When you hear the term black radical, how do you react to that?
Any black person that says, hey, you know what, America's racist and it needs to change, they're black radical. They'd rather shoeshine boys and tap dancers. Somebody who smiles in a politician's face, yes, sir, master, sir, everything is good. We're going to sit back and wait. No, that is not this movement. This movement is knocking on politicians' doors, standing outside and saying, you are going to change this system or we will remove you from office.
The Newsoms are gradually stepping back from the protests so they can march on with their legislative agenda. They're also forming coalitions with companies to provide more entrepreneurial and educational opportunities for young people of color. From the Bronx, Sarah Wallace, News 4 New York.